When you think of great Premier League volleys, you probably think of...
Yeboah with a chance! Oh, stunning goal!
Or...
Di Canio! Oh, I do not believe that!
Or maybe... Chances are you don't think about...
Kasami! What a goal that was!
Which begs the question, did Pajim Kasami score the most underrated goal in Premier League history? It's a tale that involves dodgy dial-up, complaints about Italian construction standards, and one of the most infamous wheeler dealers in world football. And it starts with a badly behaved teenager. See, in 2010, an 18-year-old Kasami was playing for Lazio's youth team, having joined from Grasshopper, and he was due to graduate to their reserve team. However, he disappeared for the summer, and when he re-emerged, his time in Rome was up, and he was shipped off to Bellinzona, that's in Switzerland. He then moved to Palermo, where he made quite the impression on owner Maurizio Zamparini, and that is a direct quote. So impressive was he at Palermo that he was in demand in the summer of 2011. He could have gone to Italian giants Roma or AC Milan. Instead, he chose London. But who did he go with? Arsenal, Tottenham and Chelsea had all just competed in the Champions League. Instead, he went to Fulham, who had just had their best Premier League season. Kasami made only 3 appearances for Fulham in the first 4 months of the 2012-2013 season, which brings us to January 2013. Where his story could have taken a big twist. Super agent Mino Raiola was trying to engineer a move back to Italy with a loan deal with Pescara. Everything was agreed, but it all fell apart due to bad internet connection in Raiola's hotel. Kasami did spend the final months of the season at Luzerne, again, that's in Switzerland. In fact, he was so desperate for first-team football that he took a 50% pay cut. Let's go to the start of the 2013-2014 season. Kasami was back at Fulham and in the starting lineup, but was he showing any signs of the moment of magic that was to come? Well, not particularly. In fact, this was the only goal he scored prior to October 21st. To understand fully how good this goal was, it's important to note that Kasami was left-footed, and these were all his right-footed efforts during the season, just the 3 of them, none causing too many problems. Here are his shooting stats for the season before that game at Crystal Palace. A quick scene setter before we get to the good stuff. And both teams had played 7 games in the Premier League season. Fulham had won 2, Palace had won just 1, and both were near the bottom of the table. And there was a positional change for Kasami for this match. This is where he lined up against Palace on the left side of midfield, whereas in Fulham's previous game, he was on the right side. So when the ball was on the right, Kasami drifted into the middle. And when the ball was with right-back Sasha Rita, he'd take up a position around the centre circle. Kasami was struggling to have an impact on the game. Fulham were behind. And these were his only touches of the first 18 minutes. So that might explain why the next time he found himself in the centre circle, he decided to take a risk.
Look the brighter side. Kasami produces a shout. Worthy of winning any game, never mind bringing them level. What a goal that was!
Have you ever scored a better goal?
No, to be honest.
He makes a long run. And the last thing you want, and my dulcet tones over this, just got to watch this and admire it. Absolutely sensational. Wow.
I saw Sasha having the ball, and I saw I could run in the space, and it came perfect to my chest, and I took it direct with my right foot.
It was unbelievable, because I haven't seen him do it before.
Twitter there comparing it to that famous strike by Marco van Basten. What do you make of that?
No, I think this was better.
Years later, Kasami watched the goal back, and this is how he described it. It's a goal of instinct. You score it and don't think about it too much. It was a perfect goal. With the pass, the run I made, the way I controlled it, and then hit it with my weaker foot, everything was on point.